The idea is, as the national states are unable to really practice solidarity, especially with Italy and Greece, where most of the refugees arrive, to create a European fund where municipalities, towns, which want to welcome refugees, could apply for the financing of the integration of the refugees, but additionally, and that is the most important point, for funding and for financing investments in infrastructure, etc., which they need, for instance, in housing, independently from the refugees. This should be an incentive for municipalities to do that, and this would also end the very bad competition which has shown up between the poor refugees and the poor in the towns. And this could be prepared by a multi-stakeholder group in the cities, which would give a kind of support for the administration. And in this multi-stakeholder group, employers, the organized civil society, NGOs, churches, trade unions, etc., and the representatives of the municipality administration could argue and find out if and how many they could welcome and how they could manage for the integration, also for cultural integration, etc. I'm quite sure if the European Union would do that, that would be a possibility outside, so to say, the national governments to relocate decentrally the refugees. And that could even help in the well understood interests of the national governments, these governments, because if the cities do decide voluntarily so, this would be no pretext or no argument for the national rights to reproach to the governments that they would be too welcoming refugees. And that could really bring a cultural movement into Europe and in this, and also a solidarity movement, because then a participatory movement, because the European Union would finance that, the citizens would feel and really find out in their practice of participation that they are paid by the European Union. That would be, so to say, a stronger integration of the European Union without centralizing the European Union. And I think that would be a good way to bring several advantages together. I mean, this seems to me a global movement that in general, not only about 70% to 80% of people live in bigger or less big cities, but also that they are the location where innovation for instance, mobility concepts are practiced, are where creativity and innovation are realized. And therefore, many reasons speak for the idea that the municipalities should get more support and more independent support from the level of the national governments. This is also a movement which has shown up in Quito in the Habitat 3 conference, because many municipalities make the experience that they are for a long while obliged to nothing or not to do anything, because on the national level you have elections or whatsoever. So this could be avoided if you would have more, for instance, direct funding also from the big donor organizations like the United Nations or the World Bank, etc. I think the festival on European integration, cultural diversity, etc., is extremely important, because we should not only write books or write newspaper articles, but Europe has to be felt, has to be realized also through other dimensions of art, of culture, of theater, of meeting other people, of eating together, etc. So we are not only cognitive beings, but we have emotions, we have artistic faculties, and that should be also part of the European project.